Can you guys hear me? Hello, hello. Thank you guys. Thank you talaga for being patient and staying on, and then for those coding along, thank you for trying to code along. I didn't want to waste your time waiting for me, as well as the opportunity to push our lesson forward. We are at the last phase of this first app, which is to make a basic CRUD application in Android, making use of the Firebase real-time database. So we're almost done with main activity. We've added a retrieve function. We've added the declaration of variables on top, and now we're adding the initialization for the recycler view and the rest of the objects that are needed to populate the recycler view itself. So that's also why we took a shorter time with update, delete, and insert, because it's just a couple of lines of code and we're able to accomplish that. Now, displaying data, as I mentioned 2 weeks ago, is a more involved process, and that's what you're seeing right now. So aside from the initial objects that we created last time, there's a ton of code that we're adding now. So we'll add one more, and that's the code for the retrieve button. So do retrieve. And I'll add that in. We'll run it next time because I know it's 5, and for some like Ricky, who I hope is still around, because I know Ricky is currently like 4 in the morning or 5, 8, 3 a.m., something like that. So this is the last one, and I'll put the code in now. So for those who are excited to finish it, you can finish it. If I can find my code. And so one thing you'll notice with retrieve is it's actually just 2 lines of code. So ito lang siya. It calls the adapter again, and then it reassociates the adapter with the recycler view. Okay, so bakit maigsi lang si show records? Because the retrieve function is just short, because the bulk of the logic for retrieve is in the retrieve function. So the logic that actually gets the data back or gets the data from Firebase is already in the retrieve function. So that's why when we need to actually retrieve the data, we call this function. And when this is called, it's used to populate the adapter. So you'll see what happens with the adapter is we are we're refreshing the adapter object, and it takes 2 arguments. The first argument is the context. So where will it be? It will be in the application, kaya this. Where will the data come from? It will come from retrieving the data through the retrieve function here on top. So when we want to refresh the data in the recycler view, 2 things happen. The adapter gets refreshed first, and then the adapter gets associated with the recycler view again. And so the last thing we'll do is we'll add these 2 pieces of code, so these 2 lines of code to retrieve. And I'll run this next week. For those who want to try it out, you of course can try it out. And then And then I'll be posting the code later on tonight. So for those who are having problems, for example, or for those who are encountering some errors, you can use the code later on to check what you have. In case you haven't checked NEO since the academic break, I've uploaded a PowerPoint that repeats update, insert, and delete. So if you want a reference for that, it's a PowerPoint in NEO right now. And then I'll also be making one for this, for the displaying data portion, because it needs its own PowerPoint. Okay, but if you're excited and you want to try it out, the code here should be enough for it. And I do understand it's really complicated code, so I'll be posting the code later on as reference for everyone. All right, so with that being said, again, I'd like to thank everyone for staying with the session. And then I'll ask, are there any questions as of the moment? Questions or clarifications? Thank you for the question, Daniel. So for the midterms, actually, it won't be hard. If you remember MobCom 1, I'll basically be asking people to submit their ideas for an application. So I'll be posting your midterm requirements before the week ends. And you can read up on that. But if you guys remember MobCom 1, it will basically be an application idea that you can work on for your final project in MobCom 2. So thank you for the question, Daniel. And I'll try to post it within the week so that it doesn't... You guys, those who want to start it early, can start it early. In case ayaw nyong magsabay-sabay yung mga midterms yung next week. Alright? Any other questions? So, if there are no more questions, again, guys, I appreciate your patience for staying on. Hopefully, some of you got it working. Again, if not, I'll be posting the code. And it's midterms next week. We most likely won't have a sync session, but I will be online in case anyone wants to ask their questions. But other than that, enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you, thank you, thank you for joining me today. It should be in NEO. I'll check again, Adrian. Because I did say earlier that I posted it on NEO. But if it's not, then... it just means hindi nag-sync ng tama si Nino. Okay, I see what happened. As usual, hindi sinink ni Neo yung... I'll upload the files later on. So, again, thank you guys. And utang ko sa inyo yung mga files. I'll be uploading them tonight. With that being said, thank you. Enjoy the rest of your day. And I'll see you... well... I won't see you guys next week. I'll be online. So for those who want to consult or anything like that, I will be online. good luck sa mga midterms niyo. Alright, thank you everyone.